Hi, let's continue. Now I wanted to consider some most elementary applications of vector calculus, which we developed last time, to problems of dynamics. First, second, Newton's law. Suppose we have a mass m, body of a mass m, moving along some trajectory, and so the position vector r depends on t. And there is some force F, which is a vector, also depending on T. And the body is moving under this force. Then the second Newton's law says that F of T equals M times A of T. So what is A? A of T equals a second derivative. It's acceleration. No, or equivalently, A of T equals F of T divided by M. This is the equivalent form of the second Newton's law. So the difference with the most elementary cases is that here R and F are vector functions. So this is the true formulation of Newton's law. So let me consider a couple of examples of this. First example is motion in the gravitation field. So we consider the motion of a body, small body, which is tossed in the presence of gravitation of Earth. Now, all this happens in not a large space, so that we can assume that the Earth is horizontal and flat, and the force of gravitation acts vertically. Then we know that the force, gravity force, which is acting on the body, equals minus mgk. K is the vertical vector, unit vertical vector. So if it is x, it is y, it is z. So this is vector K. And the force is directed downwards. So therefore we have here minus. Now let's find the trajectory of the body. So by this formula, A equals, I suppress T, T is assumed, so everything depends on T, but the force is constant, it does not depend on T, equals F of F divided by M, so F equals minus mgk divided by m. So a equals m and m cancel, minus gk equals 0, 0 minus g. Simply so. Now, what is a? A equals dv dt. So v equals integral a dt, it is a, plus constant, which we denote by v0. V0 is a constant vector, equals integral minus gk dt plus v0 equals minus gtk plus v0. So this is the velocity. Now, v of t equals dr dt. R of t equals integral v of t dt plus some r0. It is a constant displacement vector, equals integral minus gtk plus v0 dt plus r0. No, k is constant, v0 is constant, so it is minus gt square over 2 times k. Plus v 0 t plus r 0. So this vector equation for the trajectory of the body. Now, to make this more concrete, let's consider example. R0 equals 0, 0. So we start at the z-axis for z equal h. V0. Assume that our motion happens in the plane YZ plane. So this is our coordinate system. It is X, it is Y, it is Z. So suppose it happens in this YZ plane. Then initial vector velocity is a vector is lying in the yz plane, so the first component is zero. So v0, zero, zero, say uw, two components. then I want to find the trajectory. All the body will move in, so let us substitute here R of t equals minus gt square over 2k, it is 0 minus gt square over 2, it is the first term, plus v0 is 0 u v, 0 t u t w, plus 0 0 h, it is initial position of the body, equals 0 t u minus gt square over 2 plus t w plus h. No, it is a parametric equation, t is a parameter of some curve in the yz plane. So the first coordinate is always zero, so we are in the yz plane. So let's find the equation of the trajectory. Z is a function of y. So from the here we have that y equals tu. Tu. U is a given constant. T equals y over u. Now substitute it here. Z equals minus g t square y square over 2u square plus tw, t is y over u, w over u y, it is this plus h equals z equals minus g 2 u square y square plus w u y plus h. Now what is this? This is a quadratic polynomial. This is a negative, independent if u is positive or negative, it's negative. So the graph of this function is parabola. So we have this is trajectory. It is a curve in the yz plane. It is parabola such that its branches go down. Now we know very well the trajectory of a tosset body is parabola, and here we see how it is demonstrated. No, it is elementary example. Consider another elementary example. Circular motion. So it is a motion in the XY plane, no, Z, given by equation R of T equals rho cosine omega T, rho sine omega T, zero. So it is a motion along the circle of the radius rho in the xy plane, such that its circular frequency is omega. So the period of this rotation is 2 pi divided by omega. So it is one turn around this curve is 2 pi divided, takes 2 pi divided by omega. Suppose we have a body, again, of mass m, which is moving along this curve. Now, how can we make this body move along the circle? You tie it to the center of the circle, O, by a inextensible string, yes, or the rope. Yes, so this rope pulls the body to the center with some force F. So let's find this force F. F equals M A equals M R double prime of T. Now let's find the second derivative. R prime of T equals differentiated minus rho omega sine omega T rho omega cosine omega T and zero. It is R prime, R double prime of T equals differentiate again minus rho omega square cosine omega T minus rho omega square sine omega T and zero equals minus rho omega square is permanent minus rho omega square cosine omega T sine omega T zero. But this is again our R cosine rho cosine equals minus omega square rho. Let me put it here. Rho and rho R. And so the force F, which pulls the body to the center, equals F of T minus M omega square R of T. Yes? By the second law, Newton's law. So this is the equation, the well-known equation of centripetal force. Now, one more this time maybe less elementary example is the following. Angular momentum and torque. We have a body of mass m. These are our coordinate x, y, z. Is moving with some velocity v, mass of the body m, and its position vector is r. R and v depend on t, usually. Then we can define the angular momentum. M equals r cross v. So we have this vector r, this vector v. So this vector is perpendicular to r and to v, and directed so that r, v, and m form a right triangle. So in this case, this vector looks inside the whiteboard. For example, in the previous example, r equals rho cosine t, rho sine t, 0, r of t. V equals minus rho omega sine t, rho omega cosine t, 0. And in this case, m equals r m r cross v, v is a vector, equals m times, now let's write the determinant. R is it is I j k rho cosine cosine omega t sine omega t. Cosine omega t, let me write it wider, rho sine omega t, 0, minus rho omega sine omega t, rho omega cosine omega t, 0, which is equal m times I, here is j, and here is k. m, so I times this determinant, which is 0, j times this determinant with minus, which is 0, and remains k times we have rho cosine omega t, rho sine omega t, we have to take this minor, minus rho omega sine omega t, rho omega cosine omega t equals, so it is rho m times rho square omega, and here rho cosine square, plus sine square, cosine square omega t plus sine square omega t times k. Now this is 1 equals m rho square omega times k. So in this case, let me draw it here. The body is moving along this circle in the xy plane. And the angular momentum is directed along the z-axis, is proportional to k, and you can see that this coefficient is positive, is omega is positive. So if it is m. So this is, in this case, so the body is rotating this way, and in the x, in the horizontal plane, xy plane, and angular momentum is vertical. So this is angular momentum. Now I have to define the second component, torque. What it is? Again, suppose we have a body. Its position vector is r, and there is a force which is acting on this body. It is a vector f, and then torque. It is Greek letter tau equals r cross f. Now let's consider the following question. If some force is acting on the body, it changes its angular momentum. So how to learn how does it change? So what is the analog of the second Newton's law for the angular momentum? And here we have the following theory. If the body is moving along some trajectory in space, and some force F is changing its trajectory, changing its velocity, then it changes its torque, its angular momentum, dm dt equals tau as a function of t. So angular momentum is the torque replaces the body. So if you write the second Newton's law, then you have that the force equals mass times acceleration. Acceleration is the time derivative of velocity. In fact, mass times velocity is what's called momentum or linear momentum. Here we have analog of this for the angular momentum. Now let us try to prove it. Proof. So M equals R cross MV. Tau equals R cross F. So dm dt equals, no, m is a constant, m times d dt r cross v. Yeah? This is m is here, and r cross v is what remains of angular momentum. R depends on t, and V depends on t. And we have derivative of their cross product. But we have seen already that here we can use the Leibniz rule. No, Leibniz rule number 4 for the cross product of vector functions. Equals M times dr dt cross V plus R cross dV dt. Now, dR dt is V equals M V cross V plus R cross dV dt is A. Everything depends on t. Now, V cross V is zero. Yes, V cross V is zero. No, simply because if you change places, then on one hand, the cross product changes sign or changes direction to opposite. On the other hand, nothing changes. Yes? So the only vector such that this vector equals to minus the same vector is a zero vector. So this is zero. So equals M times R cross A. Now, what is R cross A? R A equals F divided by M. Yeah? So, equals M R cross F divided by M. Now this M and this M cancel equals simply R of T cross F of T. But R cross F is a torque. Yeah? Is the torque. This is what we wanted to say. So I start from dm dt, and after a couple of lines of transformations, I found torque. So it's okay. Theorem is proved. There is a remarkable particular case of this theorem. Namely, if torque of T is zero, yes, then M of T is constant. Now, in fact, dm dt equal torque. If torque is zero, dm dt equals torque. If torque is zero, then dm dt, zero, zero vector, equals zero vector, and a vector function such that its derivative is zero vector is constant. M of t equal constant. Yeah. So the only thing how to find a good example when the torque is zero. So it is the case of central force. What is central force? Central force is a force directed to the center, to the origin O. Yeah? So F of T equals some constant, no, function, scalar function, K of T times R of T. Yes, in this case we have this origin O, it is R of T, and F is directed, this our body, F of T, is directed, no, it can be directed this the same direction, or can have opposite direction, but it should be parallel or anti-parallel to the position vector. Yes? Now, example. Suppose we have a sun. We have a planet. And this planet, sun has the mass, say, m sun. This has a mass m planet. Yes, and the force, which gravitation force F, is so this is position vector R, and gravitation force F equals minus G M mass of sun, mass of planet, divided by distance from sun to the planet, it is R cube times R. So we know that the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. and directed along the distance, but in opposite direction, parallel to this, anti-parallel to the distance, to the position vector. So it should be drawn as this f. And so here is minus some constant times r divided by length of r cubed. So all in all, it is magnitude of this vector, of the length of this vector f, is inversely proportional to the square of length of r. So f equal is length of r to the minus 2. Yeah? So the most important here is that the force is always directed in the direction of the sun. Of the sun is at the center. Yes? And then we have that torque equals R cross F equals some constant R cross R. Yes, after all, this is a scalar, yes, as a number. So as a vector, f is proportional to r, and r cross r is zero. Yes. So we, in the case of central force, we have the following conclusion. If f of t is a central force, then M equals R cross V, MR cross V equals constant. Now we can consider, for example, the following system, which is maybe simpler than the planets. So suppose we have a horizontal board, yes, horizontal plane, and we have here a small hole in this plane. We have a body which is moving on this plane, yes, no, without friction. Suppose there is no friction, and this body it has a string attached, and this string goes to the hole, and then goes down. And here we can arbitrarily pull this rope or this string down or upward as we wish by arbitrary load, so it this displacement depends of time. So if you pull it 1 centimeter down, then the length of this part of the rope is also reduced by 1 centimeter. So we can prescribe arbitrary radius as a function of t, arbitrary length of this position. So it is r of t, a displacement vector, but modulo r of t, magnitude, is arbitrary function of t. Yeah, we can do it. And then however we choose this function, the angular momentum m equals mr of t cross v of t, v is velocity, it is constant. Now, in particular, if it is, say, initially is moving along some circle, yes, so we keep first some time we keep this length constant and it moves along the circle. Then we pull this rope down and we reduce the radius of the circle. So it was say rho 0 and it becomes rho 1. If you remember that if the angular velocity is omega, then we have that m equals m rho omega square. Yeah, it is no model times k. So this is the angular moment m. It is a vector, and if we have the central force and the rope established center force, because it always pulls the body toward this small hole, then we can find that, let me write it here, that m1 initially m0, so initially equals m rho 0 omega square k, and m1 after we reduced this length from rho 1 rho 0 to rho 1 equals m rho 1 say omega 0 omega 1 square k. And by the because of conservation of the angular momentum, it is constant, we can write m rho 0 omega 0 square equals m rho 1 omega 1 square. And so we can cancel m and write that rho 1 rho 0 I would say no omega 1 square omega 0 square equals rho 0 rho 1. So omega 1 square equals rho 0 rho 1 omega 0 square, or omega 1 equals square root of rho 0 divided by rho 1 omega 0. So if you reduce this length of the rope, say make it 1/4, then the angular velocity 1 minute. Yeah. No. Rho square omega. I am sorry. Rho 0 square omega, I'm sorry, rho 1 square omega, I forgot what was in my previous lecture, square omega, rho 1 square omega. Omega 1, omega 0 is rho 1 square, rho 1, rho 0 square, rho 1 square. So, omega 1 equals omega 0, rho 0 square, rho 1 square. Now it is perfect. So if we reduce this length by 1/2, then the angular velocity will grow 4-fold. And the linear velocity will be doubled. Yes? So if rho 1 equals 1/2 rho 0, then omega 1 equals 4 omega 0. And modul V1 equals 2 magnitude V0. Yes, now it is correct. Now that's it. We established you can perform this experiment with your body. Just expand your arms to the sides, then start turning with some speed, and then bring them back to your body, and you'll see that you will experience a faster rotation. Yes. I think you had something like this at high school, but here we considered just one body moving around under the influence of one force. So in the near future we consider many material points moving under the influence of many forces. So for example, it can be a solid body, for example a solid disk, and we will different problems about the angular momentum and torque in this distributed systems of materia. But this is the first example and at least one meaningful experiment. Okay, so let me finish today. Have a good time. Bye.